No! I don't need it. I will not have an all-out panic attack. It's really a matter of mind over matter.
It's here if you need it, okay?
I don't. See? It's passing. And I'm steady, and I'm focused, and I am really very terrific.
Yes, you are. Mm-hmm. And I can assure you this visit will be terrific, too.
Okay.
Lois, just put your trust in Grandmother. She will have Carmine eating out of the palms of her hand.
I very much doubt she's going to be serving Blue-Hoos.
She'll be happy to if you recommend it.
Can you just picture it? There's Reggie handing them out on a silver tray while every one of the quartermaids' mouths are turning blue out of sheer politeness. No, think work.
Great idea.
Yes, great idea. Thank God I scheduled Mary May for a recording session today, because as soon as she opens her mouth with the very first note, I will be fine. Yes, I will.
Listen, the only business that I have to take care of today is a conference call to Germany. Why don't I set that up here and stick around, give you some moral support?
No, I refuse to be stressed. I will treat this as business as usual, but thank you very much, and everything will be fine. And you know what? I thank you, and you can stay. Please stay, and I'm going to go into the studio and check out, make sure everything is okay with the setup.
Lois, it'll be fine. Revised figures to you first thing, Herr Mueller. Entschuldigen Sie, Herr Hausmann. Ich habe gesagt, wir werden Ihnen die Ziffern sofort per Fax schicken. Vielen Dank. Auf Wiederhören. Good morning, Jason.
Your German's pretty sharp there, Ned.
No, it's rusty, and I'm afraid I'm losing my French too for lack of use.
Now, that would be a shame.
Came by to see Mary May. I think it'll be a while.
Actually, no, I came to see you.
What's up?
I want to go to Paris.
Don't we all? Weren't you just there?
Yeah, actually, and I'm going back over spring break with Keisha Ward. Provided, I can use a plane.
Paris in spring. Sounds romantic. But the company jet. Jason, that's an extraordinary request coming from you.
Well, there's a first time for everything,
I guess. But you know, we like to keep the jet restricted for corporate purposes.
Yeah, right. You're like your trips to Puerto Rico and Bermuda, and Mom bringing Paige and Emily back from Arizona, the regular family ski trips. Like, Ned, of course, AJ wouldn't even ask. He'd just call the airport and order up like a ham sandwich.
True, but whisking a young lady off to Paris, that's more AJ style, too.
Well, you wouldn't be getting judgmental on me, would you, cousin? Have I ever batted an eye at anything you've done?
No. Jason, you are, it is well known, the most generous-hearted, sweet-natured, non-critical member of this family.
Does that mean I get the plane?
How does Mary May feel about this?
Well, Keisha hasn't brought it up yet. There's really no point unless we can get there. This would mean a lot to me.
I can see that. Tell me when you want to go. I'll set it up.
Oh, thanks.
I hope Mary May is as soft as I am. Does the family know about this, or do I keep quiet?
No, please. Please, nobody knows yet. Please.
All right.
Good morning.
Hi.
Good morning.
Come on in.
Gorgeous out there.
It certainly is.
I love the smell of that damp April earth and lilac daffodils. I want a picture.
So gorgeous. You're a
Thank
picture
you.
Yourself, Mary May.
Well, I am Thank so you. Glad that you're raring to go, because so are we. The studio is all set. The engineer is in there. So you tell me, what do you want to start with today?
Well, I don't know. I don't want to do the blues on such a fine morning. So I was figuring we'd do something upbeat, like Sunny Side of the Street.
That sounds perfect to me. Why don't you get yourself warmed up and I'm going to finish drafting this press release while the thoughts still hold. So why don't you show her in?
All right, I'll
show her where everything is.
Right, thanks.
Okay. Have fun.
All right, sweetheart.
Mary May Ward. Yada, 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 yada. Next. Triumphant return. Yada, yada, yada. Hi. I bet you I know who you are. Well, how's my favorite doggy mama doing? Come on in, come on in. You must be Emily Bowen, right? Well, I'm Lois. Lois Marie Cerullo Ashton, I'm married to Ned. Pleased to meet you.
Me too.
Yeah. So have you got down who's who among the Qs yet?
Well, let's see. Lois is the one with the record company.
Mm-hmm.
And your parents are coming to visit?
Yeah, right.
Sorry, I didn't mean to bother you. Annabelle sort of dragged me down here.
Oh, no, that's no problem. Annie, she hangs out down here at L&B a lot. We think she's looking for an alternate career in the music business. Oh, please, sit down, sit down. So, how do you like the puppy?
He's cute. I thought there'd be more, though.
Yeah, so did everybody, but what the heck? There are advantages to being an only child, I guess.
Are there?
Well, I always thought there were. I mean, I come from a pretty big brood myself. We're always kicking and pushing each other to get Mom Pop's attention first. I guess there are good and bad sides to both, huh?
Probably. Mm. So is this where you work?
Live and work, yeah. The recording studio's right in there, and we just started a recording session. Would you like to stay and listen?
Could I really?
Sure, why not? I own the place. Let's go. Annie, you're gonna have to stay here, though.
Stay, okay.
Come on.
Rose, what was the medicine I'm taking?
Hey, everybody behave yourselves. I have a guest here from the big house I want you all to meet. That didn't sound right, did it? I mean, a very special house guest of the families. Okay, this is Emily Bowen. Emily, this is Mary May Ward. She is our newest recording artist.
Hi, Emily.
And this is my husband, Ned Ashton.
Hi, Emily.
And this is Donovan, our engineer.
Hi, Emily.
Okay. Oh, Mary May, you don't mind if she sits in on the session, do you?
Are you kidding? You know how much I hate playing to a bare old microphone. Have a seat, honey.
Right over here.
Yes?
Sit yourself down. Let me take your jacket.
Hey.
What do they call these things?
Okay. Mary May, we're going to run the track whenever you're ready. Okay.
Grab your coat, get your hat, leave your worries on the doorstep. Just direct your feet to the sunny side.
Can't you hear
that little bag? That happy tune is your step. Life can be so sweet on the sunny side of the street. I used to walk in the shade with my blues on parade, but now I'm not afraid, 'cause I'm a road who's crossed over. If I never, 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 never have a cent, I'll be rich as Rockefeller. I got gold dust at my feet on the sunny side. On the sunny side. On the sunny side of the street. We don't bow.
Woo! lucky to have her. And am I great at zeroing in on magnificent talent? Huh?
All of the above.
Yeah, I think that's a wrap for today because we got some really great stuff.
Oh, I hope so.
Yeah.
Thanks for letting me see you sing. It was cool.
Thank you for listening, sweetheart.
Oh, boy. If we're done here, that means we're getting much closer to the 0 hour, which is my parents' arrival. Oh.
You not like your parents?
What? Are you kidding? I love my parents. They're the best. They're the greatest. They're just the combination of his folks and my folks. The mind boggles. Okay.
Well, honey, I would suggest that you just boggle down a nice warm bath, possibly with bubbles. And just sit back and relax.
Excellent advice. You do that. I'll take Emily back up to the house and check on things up there.
Uh-huh. Well, I'm going to have to go now.
Okay. Well, Mary May, can we bring my parents over to your house tomorrow afternoon for a visit? I would really love for them to meet you and vice versa.
I would be delighted. And Emily, I hope you can come and listen to us anytime, okay?
Anytime at all, for that matter.
Okay. Thanks. Let me stay there the whole entire time. The music felt so good, I just wanted to get up and dance. Of course, I had to keep quiet.
May I say her deportment was perfect?
I'm going to go see if Mom's awake yet and tell her. Maybe Lois will let her sit in sometime.
God bless you. That is the first time I have seen that girl happy since she and Paige arrived.
It was fun. And I have to say, Lois was wonderful with her. Mm. I keep discovering new facets to this amazing woman I married.
Well, she's remarkable. I hope you know how lucky you are, and I hope you make sure you hang on to her.
I do, and I plan to. And to that end, may I ask a favor of you?
Shoot.
Lois has worked herself into a frenzy over her parents' visit.
And, she's worried about what they'll think of us. I don't blame her.
She's worried about World War III erupting at the dinner table. Her father already loathes anyone I'm related to in principle.
And you're afraid Edward isn't going to behave.
On the nose. So, do you think you could sort of ride shotgun with Grandma there in order to keep him in line?
Sounds like fun. Trying to control Edward is always exhilarating. I'll do my best.
Thanks. And have I told you how great it is to have you home?
Thanks.
Oh, I'm not kidding. It was a real plus having her. Emily livened everything up.
Well, you seem to have done the same for her.
Well, that's when the kid you got there, isn't she?
And Lois, I really want to meet your parents, but I think after that, him and I are going to head upstairs and have dinner. Maybe we can do more tomorrow.
Oh, hey, look, I understand. When you feel nice and rested, you just come and see us at the gatehouse and we'll give you a tour of our little magical musical kingdom, okay?
Oh, I like that. Mr. and Mrs. Cerullo have arrived.
Courage. Holy mackerel.